In this video, you will learn to create histograms using StatCrunch. The data set I'll be using is called exam scores. This contains one column of 23 exam scores from an introductory statistics course. Let's begin by creating a histogram for the exam 2 column with frequency on the y-axis. To do so, under the graph menu, we'll choose histogram, and we'll select the exam 2 column and click Compute. Notice by default, StatCrunch will automatically choose a starting point, bin the data, and plot the frequency of each bin. For this example, the histogram has a starting point of 50 and a bin width of 5. These bins are non-overlapping and including the left edge and excluding the right edge. So for example, a score of 80 falls in the 80 to 85 bin, not the 75 to 80 bin. Now let's adjust our histogram to show relative frequency or density on the y-axis. To do so, under the Options menu, we'll choose Edit. This takes us back to the original window where we built our histogram. In this window, StatCrunch has other options for the user to customize their histogram. In the Type box, I'll change it from frequency to relative frequency. Click Compute. The resulting histogram shows the relative frequency for each bin. StatCrunch also allows the user to change the starting point and/or the bin width. To do so, back under Options and Edit, you will see the bins. You can enter a start at point and a width. For this example, I'll choose a width of 10 and leave the start at the default. I'll click Compute. And now you'll notice that the bin widths are larger and a value of 10. Another option StatCrunch allows the user is to add a distribution overlay. Back under Options again, under Display Options, you'll see a box labeled Overlay Distribution. For this example, I'll choose Normal. Notice once I chose Normal, StatCrunch then offered the option to specify the parameters for the distribution. By default, StatCrunch will estimate the best fitting parameters. In this case, StatCrunch will use the sample mean and the sample standard deviation for the normal distribution. I'll click Compute, and the resulting histogram has a red curve overlaid reflecting the best fitting normal distribution with the mean and standard deviation shown in the title of the histogram. Lastly, StatCrunch can also show the numerical value of each of the bins. Back under Options, back under Display, I can show the value above each bar for each bin. I'll choose that option. I'll click Compute. And now StatCrunch is displaying the numerical value above each bar for that bin.